Are we set? Cameras are rolling. Ready?
All right.
Yeah, good evening. We have with us captain of our team, Virat Kohli. Would request everyone to keep your phones on silent, please, and please raise your hands before asking a question. Who would want to go first?
Captain, after performance like that, this is bound to be asked about the preparation. But in reality, against bowling of that quality, is there much else that you could have done than what Philander produced today?
We were very well prepared. I don't think we felt lack of preparation. Even they got out for 130 in the second innings, and they play here all the time. So it was a wicket where, you know, things were happening on every day. I think, look, we let ourselves down with the bat for sure. Losing wickets in bunches never helps in winning test matches or consolidating your position. Also, you know, we rectified the errors that we made in the first innings by letting them off after having them 12 for 3. We plugged that gap pretty nicely in the morning today. Getting a target of 208 felt chaseable, felt very realistic. But again, we needed someone to go out there and get a 75 or 80 and not, 20, 25 and 30 runs. And we wanted one big partnership to, get the job done, which we failed to do. And again, we lost 4 wickets in 4 overs. So that, if you do that, it's very difficult for you to come back and win test matches from there. But, being put under pressure twice, I think we came back really nicely into the game and gave ourselves a fair chance of winning this test match, even after not having played our best cricket. So, we can take a lot of positives out of this, but at the same time, we need to be realistic and understand our mistakes and correct them in the next one. Of course, 20 wickets to win the test match is obviously the priority. But if your batsmen don't bat well, then it does not matter. If you're not getting close to their total, then it does not matter if you've taken 20 wickets or not. As I said, we needed to bat better than what we did. I think Hardik showed great character in the first innings to get us to that total. But again, if we had them 50 or 60 less in the first innings where we let them off in the last few wickets, things could have been different. Even now we lost by 70 odd. This might sound big, but we understand where the game was. And, even today, feel really disappointed by how things went on. We needed probably, if not one big partnership, then maybe every wicket, adding 30, 35 odd would have done the job for us also. So, we needed to show more character with the bat. There's no question about it.
Virat, first inning as well as in the second inning, we saw that after here.
Oh, sorry.
after say 30 or 40 overs, things slightly eased out the way even Hardik batted, second inning Ashwin and Bhumi, the way they applied. Do you think that hanging on for first 40 overs is going to be the key?
Well, obviously, you want their bowlers to come back for second and third spells. That's the only way you can check how good they can be even in the third spell also. As I said, we failed to do that. We need to apply ourselves better. At the same time, we need to have intent because the kind of bowling attack they have, especially on these pitches, they get extra bounce and they get extra pace off the wicket. So you can't even be in a zone of not having intent and wanting to see off 35, 40 overs. You need to find the perfect balance, to do well in South Africa, especially where there's more bounce. As I said, you can't be casual. At the same time, you can't have loose shots also. And I said in the post-match as well, the credit has to go to their bowlers also because they create relentless pressure. And, it's something that we need to counter. Maybe we need to come out and be more positive in the next innings. Take their bowlers on and get quick runs on the board, just like they did when they were put under pressure. I think that's probably one way of encountering, that kind of bowling attack. But again, they force you to play good cricket in every over that you play against them, which I think is a big credit to their bowling attack. But as batsmen, we definitely need to step up.
Yeah.
There are just some your views on the pitches. Didn't seem unplayable, just maybe lack of application by both sides. And then just something about Vernon Philander, you took a lot of the pace and bounce, but you obviously had some other attributes as well.
Well, he's a different kind of bowler. You know, when you have in the second innings they had only three quicks. That's why I said, you know, that effort was really good because they only had three bowlers with Dale not being able to compete. But see, Vernon has different strengths. He's always pitched the ball in those, you know, areas of uncertainty, and that's his strength. You know, he gets the ball to seam both ways also. So, as I said, you have to be at the top of your game every time you play against this bowling attack because of the variety as well. So, you know, he bowled really well in the second inning, especially when the ball wasn't doing so much. You know, at one stage when me and Rohit were playing, we felt pretty comfortable. But again, as I said, we lost four wickets in four overs, which doesn't really help, you know, the team's cause, even especially when you're chasing a low total. So, but yeah, he bowled really well in the second innings.
There's something about the pitch.
The pitch was outstanding. I really liked the kind of wicket this was. I think it was great for Test cricket, and definitely getting a result within 4 days, even, you know, losing a day's play, and not one-sided. I mean, both sides were in it, you know, at different stages. So, I think as a team, we really enjoyed being a part of this Test match, and so did South Africa. And I think it's a great way to start the series.
Anna?
It's not every day that an exceptional batsman and vice captain of the team is dropped from here. What's the logic behind that?
Well, you know, we decided to go on current form. Rohit had scored runs in the last three Test matches that he played, and you know that, and he was batting really well, even in the series against Sri Lanka. So, you know, we did that similar thing with Shikhar as well some time back, and you know, look, these things can be always, you know, can be looked at in hindsight, thinking, you know, what if or what if not, but we decided to go in with one combination, and you know, current form was definitely the criteria. Well, look, as I said, I mean, you can't just stand there and, you know, take whatever's coming your way and not have intent at all. You might get out, but, you know, it's important to keep coming at the bowler and, you know, making them feel that if you make an error, I'm going to score. So I think that message needs to go across pretty strongly, and you need to do that as a batting unit, you know, collectively. I think Hardik did that really well in the first innings. Ash was really positive as well in the second innings. But if, you know, 5-6 of us can have that mindset, starting from the top, you know, that will really create that sort of momentum for us as a batting unit, which I think we lacked in both the innings. You know, a brilliant performance got us back into the game with the bat. Otherwise, you know, we were pretty similar to the situation we were in second innings also. So we definitely need batsmen to apply themselves and show more character.
Last.
Well, a left-hander always helps. You know, that's what we felt. They've got two, including Quinton, in their batting order. And yeah, I mean, you know, it's difficult for bowlers to set up their lines and lengths every time if the strike's rotating well. So yeah, that, you know, it has worked for us in the recent past, and that is something that definitely is a combination that a lot of teams go with in international cricket, especially because you don't want the bowlers to settle against one kind of batsman at one line and length, you know, especially with the new ball. So we have to, you know, try and create plans that we feel will not let the opposition gain momentum from very early on in the game, and that was the idea behind it.
Final two.
We are having not crossed the line at Newlands and now going to the high fall, which is usually more poison bounce. Has the challenge not just become simple?
No, I don't think so. I mean, look, they have collapsed as well, you know. Even in the first innings, if you take AB's innings out, and Faf to an extent, you know, the batting has not really clicked together for them either. So we feel that we are in the game. You know, we felt we were in the game here as well throughout. You know, today we felt they're going to come out and play with more intent, but that wasn't the case. You know, they were quite hesitant when they lost a few wickets. So I think if we get a lively wicket again, we can really exploit their batting also. And if we apply ourselves good well enough, then, you know, as I said, we will give ourselves a chance again to have a crack at a result, which was the case in this game also. You know, we feel really disappointed. Everyone in the change room is really disappointed with today's effort, because we were feeling really good, you know, at lunch when we restricted them under 210. And to not having got the job done, it hurts, and it should hurt, because that's the only way you can rectify mistakes and come out with more motivation in the next game.
Virat, do you feel for your bowlers? I mean, the fact that first session they wiped out the, you know, 8 wickets, I mean, it's very unusual for our pacers. It's rare to do it overseas and then, you know, it gets wiped out by a poor batting performance. Do you feel for the bowling unit? I'm not just talking about them.
Yes, definitely. We feel for them. Because they bowled their heart out, we had a chat this morning. We wanted people to step up and get us wickets, and you know, a guy like Jaspreet bowled beautifully in his first test match. You know, he troubled the batsmen a lot this morning. Shami bowled his heart out. Bhuvi was good as well, and you know, not having done the job with the bat, obviously they will also be gutted about it, because they really bowled their heart out. But at the same time, as I said, they know that they can repeat that. You know, they can repeat that performance, and if we get a lively wicket again, we can exploit those conditions also. But we need to be better with the bat. There's no question about it. Again, the same point. You know, we can't have collapses like we did. Maybe 2 wickets together is fine, but 3 and 4 is a bit too much. You add 2 wickets to the scoreboard at any stage, it looks, you know, tougher than where you are. So we need to show more character with the bat. The bowlers are bowling really well, and if they continue with the same and we step up with the batting, I think we have a good chance of creating result opportunities again.
Thank you.
Thank you.